Right, Elmer, you know, much has been said about the POV modernization, so I want to start from a different angle. You are a second generation Francisco, I understand. It was your dad who set it up, and you're passing the baton soon to your son as well. I wonder, this POV modernization program, do you see this as the next leg of growth for Francisco Motors?
Yes, actually, yun yung ano, that's something that we are looking at. And it's really a chance, not only for Francisco Motors, but it's a chance for the Philippines to industrialize, finally. So this is our chance. So why are we giving it to foreign manufacturers when we local manufacturers can build better jeepneys than what they are doing? So that's actually our question.
Better jeepneys. Local manufacturers can build better jeepneys. That takes me to my next question. Does the local industry have the manufacturing capacity? Do we have the supply chain, the logistical chain, and the financial muscle to take on this daunting task and compete? If you think about it, with China-made cars that are very cheap, you can get them for as low as 500,000 pesos.
Yes, actually, Mimi, I've always believed that we have to think big to solve smaller problems. In fact, the jeepney manufacturing of Francisco Motors is just a tiny part of the bigger project that we are doing because we are developing a special economic zone, a 200-hectare special economic zone in Camarines Norte, of which the jeepney manufacturer is just one of those locators in that economic zone, wherein we are inviting all of the suppliers in the supply chain of the manufacturing of electric jeepneys to locate in that special economic zone. So this endeavor will generate a lot of jobs for Filipinos here at home, of which if we continue to import minibuses from other countries like China, India, or wherever, we are taking away jobs that are supposed to be for the Filipino workforce. Mm-hmm. So this is one of the reasons why Francisco Motors is doing this, to preserve or to save the jobs that are supposed to be for Filipinos and not export those jobs to other countries.
I wonder, Elmer, and this is I'm personally curious. I would like to know and visualize, how does your manufacturing facility look like today? We all know how the jeepney is iconic. It's something, it's very rich in history. But when you go to, for example, a Francisco Motors facility, what do we see? Do we see automated supply chains moving these jeepneys from one point to the next? Or is it mostly, do we see lateros? What's the plan here? Do you buy the engines abroad and then just, you know, isasalpak na lang yung katawan ng jeepney? How will this work?
Okay, actually,
how advanced?
Yes, Mimi, we have been building jeepneys for 77 years already. So ever since 1947 to 1959, lahat yan surplus. Galing yan sa military jeeps that were left by the U.S. Army after World War II. But since 1960, lahat ng jeepney na ginagawa ng Francisco Motors ay 100% brand new. So 1960, we brought in Isuzu to the Philippines. So we used Isuzu engines from Japan. Then we added Mazda in the 1970s. So dalawang engines ng Francisco Motors. So Isuzu and Mazda. But recently, since we already, dito sa POV modernization program, we already have the ano, yung EVIDA, yung Electric Vehicle Industry Development Act, which was passed last April 2022, which enables us to locally build or locally manufacture our own drivetrains, our electric drivetrains. Because of this, we will no longer be importing engines from foreign manufacturers. We will be mass producing them in our facility that we are building at Camarines Norte. So since you asked, dati, even in the 80s and 90s, without automation, without computers, ang mass production or assembly line ng Francisco Motors sa Las Piñas ay nakakagawa ng 12,000 units per year. So, ganun ang ano natin. Kasi mass production yan, hindi yan yung pok-pok-pok-pok sa backyard.
Oh, wow. All right.
Hindi ganun yan. Mass production talaga yan. Because Francisco Motors, hindi lang naman jeepney yung ginawa natin. We also built ano commercial vehicles, trucks, buses, vans, yung mga Mazda na pickups, mga vans, and also cars. We also brought in Hyundai from South Korea, sa Pilipinas, and Fiat from Italy. So marami tayong ibang ano, experience sa ibang mga vehicles, not only the jeepneys. We also have the locally developed Anfra na utility vehicle and Pinoy na utility vehicles. So basically, what we're doing right now is yung sa Las Piñas namin na, ano, na planta, we already closed it down because we're transferring to Camarines Norte sa special economic zone so that we can avail of fiscal and non-fiscal incentives from the government so that we could further lower the costs of production. So natutuwa ako dahil ang PESA, meron na silang domestic market enterprise of which we can cater to the domestic market aside from keeping on our eyes on export because in the future we will be exporting. So gagawa tayo dito ng ating mga electric vehicles. And Francisco Motors has gone full electric. So we will not be building fossil fuel powered vehicles anymore. Then aside from the battery electric vehicles, we are also going to the direction of hydrogen. So hydrogen fuel cells for our land transportation and also for our eVTOLs. eVTOLs are electric vertical takeoff and landing vehicles. So soon enough, maybe next year, you'll be seeing flying jeepneys as well.
Exciting times. But before we get to the flying jeepneys, let's talk about the special economic zone in Camarines Norte. When will it be fully operational? When are you making the big move? And how many players are currently signed up for this special economic zone? It's a 200-hectare property, you say?
Yes. So it's a 200-hectare property. Yun yung pinag-uusapan namin ni, ano, ni Governor Dong Padilla of Camarines Norte and also Director General Teo Panga ng PESA. So we will start developing the, ano, the 30 hectares out of the 200 hectares. Kasi yung 30 hectares, meron na yung ano, presidential proclamation as a special economic zone. So we can already start developing that. So nandun tayo sa ano sa point na yun ngayon, we will be starting land development, then we will be putting our equipment, our plant and equipment for the manufacturing ng ano, mass production ng jeepneys, na electric jeepneys. So we will also be mass producing the drivetrains there, your electric drivetrains and the batteries. So we will have those locally produced yung mga drivetrains, of which hindi lang yung para sa Francisco Motors. Ang plano namin, nakikipag-usap din kami sa ibang mga local manufacturers, katulad sila sa Rao. We can also supply drivetrains to them and also local manufacturers. Kasi hindi naman madamot si Francisco. So we are sharing.
So you're confident, Elmer, that you can, you know, gather the key critical suppliers needed to set up an EV supply chain in that ecozone?
Yes, Mimi. So we are starting, but alam mo, ang Francisco Motors kasi hindi kami bago dun sa electric na, ano, na space. Because since the 1980s, meron na tayong ano, electric jeepneys. Pati electric. 1980s pa. Pero of course, the battery technology back then was different. Lead acid deep cycle pa yung batteries noon. Ngayon lithium na. Then, like what I said, soon enough, maybe by next year, we will replace already the lithium batteries by with hydrogen fuel.
What is the difference, Elmer, for those who are not technical? What's the difference between EV that runs on lithium versus hydrogen fuel cell?
Number one difference is the range. So yung range niyan, ang battery kasi, ano, very limited ang range. Kasi as you add more batteries, bumibigat yung sasakyan. So yung range mo, parang hindi na nagiging efficient. So you can go as maybe 400 kilometers or 500 kilometers with hydrogen. You can have more range, like 500 to 900 kilometers.
Oh, wow.
Kasi ang battery electric, you charge it sa charging stations, of which Francisco Motors din ang maglalagay ng charging stations sa lahat ng lugar na magde-deploy tayo ng electric jeepneys. But with hydrogen, you will just refuel it with hydrogen, green hydrogen. So yun, part din yung ginagawa ng Francisco Motors in collaboration with different companies, both local and foreign, will be producing green hydrogen, yung produced by ano, by renewable sources.
Mm-hmm. All right. So let's, from this special economic zone, let's talk about your Chuper Hero program. You've actually been pitching this to government, but I heard it's taking a very long time to get approvals, considering that you plan to give away some of these EVs to drivers. How will this work? What's the business model here? You own the electric jeepneys and the operators are just partners. How about the drivers? walk us through the process.
Okay, the superhero program. First, sino mga pwedeng sumali sa superhero program ng Francisco Motors? Ito yung proposal natin sa DOTR and sa LTFRB, of which yung pag-uusap namin ay ongoing. Nagpapasalamat nga ako sa inyo pati sa ibang mga kasamahan natin sa media dahil nang dahil sa inyo medyo bumilis-bilis ng konti yung pagsagot ng LTFRB. So before our interview, I was in another interview, the new USEC of Department of Transportation, si Andy Ortega, is now coordinating with me. Mm-hmm. And he's also talking to Chairman Guadis of LTFRB on the best way forward. So I'm very optimistic na nandyan si USEC Ortega. He's been 2 days as USEC, but he was the chairman of OTC before that. Mm-hmm. I'm very confident that na medyo bibilis yung proseso okay. nito.
So what is the process? How will this work?
Yes, so the superhero program is ang pwedeng sumali dito ay yung mga jeepney operators with valid franchises. So it could be yung mga transport cooperatives, transport corporations. So ang nagbibigay naman ng valid franchises is LTFRB. So it's part of it. So lahat sila pwedeng sumali. And lahat ng sasali, meron sila mga lumang jeep. Diba? So yung mga lumang jeep nila, we can still use them to operate them and help them na lumaki yung kita nila. Because we will have the unlimited rides na tickets. Isa yan sa proposal natin sa LTFRB of which pinag-aaralan nilang mabuti. Yung unlimited rides, it's just like sa ibang developed countries na kapag sumakay ka ng train, you can buy a ticket, you can hop on, hop off unlimited times in a day or in a week or in a month. So depende sa ticket na bibilin mo. So kung kayang gawin yun ng developed countries, why can't we do it here sa Philippines? So of course, I understand that LTFRB has to follow some existing rules and regulations, existing laws. But of course, we can never have progress if we will just follow the old rules, old laws na dekada-dekada na rin katanda yung mga rules na yan. So we have to change certain things for us to have real progress. Now, why are we doing this? Ang problema kasi ng mga operators natin is the cost ng mga sasakyan. So kung ang problema nila ay cost, bakit ang solusyon is hindi pa utangin? Diba? We create a business model na hindi yung lulubog sila sa utang. We create a business model that is sustainable enough that we can actually give the jeepneys for free. Kasi dito sa model na to, we will have yung unlimited rides nga. So dito sa unlimited rides tickets na to, dyan kukunin yung sweldo ng mga drivers, dyan kukunin yung kita ng mga transport cooperatives. Of course, Francisco Motors will have a profit also because we are a social enterprise. It's a business. Hindi naman kami DSWD.
Elmer, you mentioned earlier, pwedeng gamitin ng mga operators yung mga lumang jeepney nila. So you will convert these jeepneys?
No. Pwede pa nilang gamitin yung jeepneys nila. Kasi ang rule ng LTFRB is from the approval ng LPTRP or Land Public Transport Route Plan, from that approval, binibigan sila ng 27 months or a little more than 2 years to replace the old jeepneys with modernized units. So within that
period.
Yes. So within that period, ang gagawin natin, continue pa rin. So magkoconsolidate sila, di ba? Then tuloy-tuloy pa rin, gagamitin pa rin yung mga old jeepneys nila hanggang sa unti-unti natin mapalitan ng modernized units. But the difference is wala silang kailangan bayaran. We give these jeepneys to them for free. Then, aside from that, ang maintenance ito, kasi under warranty, lifetime yung yung warranty niya. So, yun yung maganda.
Okay.
So, yes. So, ang maganda dyan, yung mga pasahero, makakatipid din sila dahil doon sa unlimited rides. So, instead of paying every time sasakay sila, they'll just be paying once in a month.
All right. Elmer, just very quickly, we're showing live footage from the Philippine Stock Exchange. This is coming to us live from Taguig. The countdown to the special bell ringing. This is for the listing of Cebulan Masters 5 billion peso follow-on offer. 3, 2, and 1. I hope we have a sound here. All right, just imagine the sound, but it's a special. We are seeing Mr. Soberano, the father, his son Joe, shaking hands now with PSC President Ramon Monson. Of course, the third guy from the bell wearing a gray suit. We just had him about a few weeks ago. That's Grant Cheng, the CFO. So again, this is for the 5 billion peso follow-on offer of Cebu Land Masters. This comprised of 5 million Series A preferred shares, 1,000 apiece issued in two sub-series, that's Series A1 and A2. The funds raised will be used to partially finance project development and capex. The Visman developer, as we reported a few weeks ago, posted a 29% growth in full year 2023 consolidated net income at 4.6 billion as revenue grew 20% to nearly 19 billion pesos. More on that later. I think we can go back to Elmer just very quickly. Hi, Elmer. Sorry about that. We just had to bring in the live shots from the stock exchange.
Yeah, actually, it's like I heard the actual ringing of the bell. Tatabi ko lang yung Philippine Stock Exchange.
Oh, all right. Elmer, just speaking of investors, Maharlika Investment Fund is keen on putting money into your project, into your ambitious plan. Where are you on that?
Yeah, we're talking. We haven't agreed on anything yet. Anything we're talking si Joel Consing, pati yung ano board ng ano na Maharlika. But what we are talking about are about the terminals, because Francisco Motors hindi lang jeepney ginagawa natin. Like what I mentioned, the manufacturing is just a tiny part of the bigger plan. Part of it is we will put up terminals, jeepney terminals. We have an ambitious plan of putting up 100 terminals. That's one for each province, 82 provinces, then 17 sa Metro Manila and one central. So ang pinag-uusapan namin ng Maharlika Investment Corporation is for them to fund the first terminal. So yun pala yung pinag-uusapan namin ngayon. Of which, ang pinag-uusapan namin is I'm coordinating with the office of House Speaker Romualdez. Because we are looking into idle government properties owned by the national government. Because with that, magiging yung non-performing asset ng government, magiging revenue generating. Aside from that, we don't have to buy the property. So makakatipid tayo doon. That's one. It could be a tripartite agreement. So owned by the national government, then Maharlika Investment Corporation may fund the development, then we can operate the terminal. Sa terminal, magkakaroon niya ng of course, yung mga modernized jeepneys natin, dyan yung terminal. We'll have service base, after sales parts, and we'll have depots for our charging stations and hydrogen. So yan yung isang pinag-uusapan namin ng MIC.
All right, how much investments will the MIC need to make this work? Because you're looking at them funding just one, the first one, right?
Yes, actually for the whole for the whole project, yung 100 terminals, that would cost us around $200 million. $500 million. But since it's one terminal, let's just do the math. It's around $5 million.
For a start.
Yes, for the for the first terminal.
Oh wow. And how do you plan to bankroll the rest of the 99 terminals that you plan to set up?
Yeah, actually, aside from internal funding, we also have ongoing negotiations with many different financing companies, financing institutions, both foreign and domestic. So yung sa foreign, medyo malaki-laki din. They're very interested. Alam mo, ang pinaka-interesado sila is the green portion of it. Kasi renewable energy, renewable sources, electric vehicles, then we're going for hydrogen. Then aside from that, I also got a pledge 2 days ago, of which ina-announce yan ngayon as we speak. Ina-announce yan ngayon ni Climate Change Commission Commissioner Albert de la Cruz sa Kapihan sa Manila Hotel. Our COO, Mr. Christian San Jose, is there with him right now. I-announce niya yan dahil nag-pledge siya na 200 million pesos para dito sa project na to. For igagawa natin ang mga electric jeepneys for us to give away for free.
And Elmer, how many electric jeepneys are you looking to give away for free again?
As many as we can, actually. Because with this business model, Mimi, we can give all jeepneys for free. With this business model that we did, yun sa superhero program, of which nilagay kuya ng klarong-klaro sa LTFRB, I understand that their hands are tied, they have to follow certain rules, but the way to move forward is to keep the communications open so we can work on possible solutions. Because we're not hindi madali naman kaming kausap.
All right.
We can make adjustments, di ba, dun sa mga policies. Pati mga kung kahit meron tayong kailangan sundin, existing policies, we can do that.
Final question, Elmer. Are you looking at welcoming new investors into Francisco Motors, maybe tapping the capital markets, going public, raising funds?
Yes, we are talking. Actually, nag-uusap kami kahit SEC, nag-uusap kami regarding that. But for now, alam mo, sabi mo nga, Mimi, it's an ambitious plan. My plan is to go for the unicorn status. So we're not going public anytime soon because we have a unique situation here and it's achievable. Di ba? Maganda na meron tayong ano, Filipino ano, owned and Filipino-grown company to become a unicorn. So a unicorn is a business that is valued at least $1 billion.
How soon?
Then we'll go public.
Okay, and when will this unicorn be born?
Ginagawa pa namin eh. So,
5 years?
We will let you know.
All right.
Hopefully before that.
All right. On that note, Elmer, thank you so much for joining us, for walking us through the manufacturing requirements of a modernized jeepney. We are very excited to see what you will do with the Chopper Hero program and for this unicorn to be born. Thank you again and have a great weekend.
Thank you, Mimi.